Okay, friends, final property to share here is the quotient of powers property. And of course, it's now we're going to start doing division. Really quick, 4 to the 5th divided by 4 to the 2nd. I can multiply it out, or I can do that very basic thing. Give me my expanded form to make it really obvious. I can simplify. That's going to give me 4 to the 3rd. The same way, because all I've done is divided it by 4, I divided it by 4, and then the next time when I divided it again and I used, let's say I went there and there, that was dividing each top and the bottom by 4 again each time. Ended up with 4 times 4 times 4, 4 to the 3rd, which of course, you guys have now learned these tricks that we've got. What did we do? What we actually said was 4 to the 5th. Minus 2, wasn't it? We said 4 to the 5th, take away the 2 at the bottom, gave me 4 to the 3rd. What's really important here is remember it must have the same base. So that's the very, very basic version. Let me make it a little bit more interesting, shall I? So here I'm going to now take it to 3, because we wouldn't want to go too far away. What have I got? I've got 3 to the 4th times 3 to the 2nd divided by 3 to the 3rd. I'm going to be systematic as ever. That's the same thing as saying 4 plus 2 over 3 to the 3rd. That's going to be 3 to the 6th over 3 to the 3rd, which is the same now. Here's my super exciting bit. 3 to the 6th minus 6th power minus the 3rd power, it's going to give me 3 to the 3rd power. Make enough sense? This was that key bit where I took the value, the power of my numerator, and I subtracted the value of my denominator. Let me challenge this one step further. If I take... let's make sure you can actually see. I'm now going to give you a to the 10th power divided by a to the 6th power times a to the 7th over a to the 4th. I noticed in the Go Formative a lot of people always went back to x. Remember, we can always have any variable letter we want to have. So here, let's start doing this. We're going to do our quotient of powers first. So I'm going to have a to the 10th minus 6 times a to the 7th minus 4. And that will give me a to the 4th, that's that friend, times, let's keep it clearer-ish, a to the 3rd. And now, remember, I'm going to now say I've got a to the 4 plus 3 power to give me a to the 7th power. Did we follow that? So first, we had two fractions multiplied by each other, but I can use my quotient of powers property. It turns into a to the 10th minus 6, a to the 7th minus 4 equals a to the 4th times a to the 3rd, which is the same as saying a to the 4th plus the 3rd equals a to the 7th, just to be very clear. Okay, I hope that makes enough sense. We'll try and do a little calculation with that in class. So now we move on to zero exponents. Talking to zero exponents, here's just something I want you to think about. If I've got 5 to the 4th power divided by 5 to the 4th power, I'm going to get a value of 1, right? Do you remember when we had that really complicated one? It still came to 1 because that's the same thing as saying 5 to the 4th power minus 4, because I'm taking this and this. 1 goes here, 1 goes there, and that's going to give me 5 to the 0 power. It's a very simple proof. Doesn't matter what my value is. If I'm able to make this equation work, then I know that when I do anything to the zero power, it's always going to equal 1. So I just wanted to show you, really, really basic. Do you remember we did our proofs? That's all I'm showing you for right now. We're going to go further and I can give you deeper proofs, but for now I want you to understand that that is my zero exponent. And finally, the power of 1. So I'm just going to hammer this one home really, really simply. If I had the number 5 to the power of 1, that is the number of 5 times itself 1 time. It's going to give me 5. Any number to the power of itself 1 time, sorry, to the power of 1 will be that number itself. It will always come back to being itself. So I told you a moment ago about the zero exponent. Zero exponent will always equal 1. To the power of 1 will always equal the same as the base. And here's the workout. Okay, so here is the working out for the super efficient work with exponents, where we're doing the quotient of powers property, which is basically the division but looks like a fraction, touched on our zero exponents, and the magic power of 1.